3 weeks ago, Islamist militant group Boko Haram kidnapped more than 200 schoolgirls from northern Nigeria. The audacious attack was just one in a long string of assaults and bombings the group has carried out since it launched an insurgency in the country 5 years ago. Now, international attention is increasing pressure on Nigeria's President Goodluck Jonathan to better respond to the violence. This week, the White House said it was supporting Nigeria's efforts to end the violence by Boko Haram, which Amnesty International estimates has killed as many as 1,500 people so far this year. So, who is Boko Haram? The group, whose name translates as Western Education is Forbidden, is fighting to impose an Islamic state on the ethnically and religiously divided Nigeria. The group emerged several years ago in northern Nigeria, as our African affairs writer explains. Here's William Wallace reporting from Abuja.
There's a long history in the north of Nigeria of Islamist sects forming and eventually confronting the state. And Boko Haram, in a sense, is the latest in a long line of these groups. Initially non-violent, but after a major confrontation with the state in the town of Maiduguri in 2009, when the leader of the group, Mohammed Yusuf, was summarily executed in custody, it became much more violent. It's very unclear now exactly how organized Boko Haram is and the extent of their links with other jihadist groups around the region, but there is considerable evidence that Boko Haram militants have trained abroad in Somalia, have links with Al-Qaeda in the Maghreb, and have used some neighboring countries, for example, as rear bases. It's the opinion of the Nigerian security services that they have become better funded over time, that their international links have become stronger over time as well. And so it's likely that there has been considerable external funding from jihadi sources. They've also benefited since the fall of Colonel Gaddafi in Libya from the massive surge of weapons imports from Libya into the area.
One of the difficulties in analyzing and responding to Boko Haram is in categorizing who actually belongs to the group. John Campbell, a former U.S. ambassador to Nigeria, explains.
We have to be careful by what we mean by Boko Haram. It's highly diffuse, it's decentralized, it's made up of a number of different strands. Some people will maintain that there's six or seven different Boko Harams.
Elizabeth Donnelly of Chatham House says that Boko Haram actually benefits from the mystique around the size and the shape of the group.
It is very important to Boko Haram, however, that it remains in the shadows, that it remains this mysterious organization, because it plays in its favor. The less it's known about Boko Haram, the more it can present itself as this tremendously well-organized, strong professional force. It may be this, but actually there's a lot of information missing.
Outrage within Nigeria about the latest kidnapping may affect support Boko Haram receives, both within Nigeria and by other jihadi groups.
The abduction of these 16 to 18-year-old girls may contribute to hardening local opinion against the group, particularly in areas where they may still have some constituency in the impoverished and remote bits of the north where they're strongest. It may also cause them some trouble with other jihadist groups who may not entirely approve of their methods.
The latest incidents have shown Boko Haram's willingness to take on so-called soft targets, such as bus stops. But the international attention the violence is receiving could also shape the future response to the group and its ability to operate.